Erythrocyte sedimentation rate measures the rate at which red blood cells settle in a vertical column of blood within a specific time frame, usually 1 hour. The result is expressed in millimeters per hour. When inflammation occurs, certain proteins in the blood, particularly fibrinogen, increase. These proteins cause red blood cells to clump together, making them heavier and leading to a faster sedimentation rate. ESR is an indirect measure of inflammation. ESR levels increase at a slow rate in response to inflammation, and can take weeks to return to normal levels, making ESR helpful in monitoring chronic inflammatory conditions. Elevated ESR levels can be indicative of various inflammatory conditions, such as infections, autoimmune disorders, and certain cancers. ESR is influenced by factors like age, gender, and other non-inflammatory conditions, making it less specific than some other inflammatory markers. C-reactive protein is a protein produced by the liver in response to inflammation. It is measured in blood and is expressed in milligrams per deciliter. CRP binds to the surface of damaged or dead cells, foreign substances, and bacteria, initiating the immune system's response to eliminate them. CRP is a more specific marker for acute inflammation. It is particularly useful in monitoring conditions such as infections, tissue injury, and cardiovascular diseases. CRP levels tend to rise rapidly in response to inflammation, allowing for a quicker detection of acute processes. It is often used to assess the effectiveness of treatment in inflammatory conditions. CRP is generally considered a more specific marker for acute inflammation, while ESR is a non-specific indicator. CRP levels rise rapidly within hours of an inflammatory stimulus, whereas ESR takes longer to show changes and peaks after a day or more. CRP is preferred for detecting and monitoring acute inflammation, while ESR is often used as a screening test for chronic inflammatory conditions. Both ESR and CRP provide valuable information about inflammation in the body. They differ in their specificity, response time, and clinical utility. Healthcare professionals often use a combination of these tests, along with other diagnostic tools, to obtain a comprehensive understanding of the patient's inflammatory status. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, share it with others, and subscribe for more.